Musa alayhi salam, his story is mentioned in so many places, and this particular ayah belongs to Surah Taha. And in this surah, Allah Azza wa Jal begins the narrative when he left his family and he saw a fire up on top of a mountain in the middle of the night. And when he gets up there, of course, he discovers that Allah Azza wa Jal is the one that's called him to it. And this beautiful conversation begins between him and Allah Azza wa Jal. Now in the course of that talk that Allah was giving him through the fire, Allah Azza wa Jal told him to throw his stick, his staff, al-asa. Al-qiha ya Musa, throw it Musa. Musa alayhi salam throws it and it turns into a hayyah, into a running snake. A poisonous snake in old Arabic is also called a hayyah. And then he tells him, khudha wa la takhaf. Grab the snake, grab it and don't be afraid. Now you tell me, as a normal human being, grabbing a snake and not being afraid, it's almost impossible. And yet Allah Azza wa Jal trained Musa alayhi salam to take this task on, to grab the snake and not be afraid. And at this point you notice Musa alayhi salam doesn't say, La astati' ya Rabbi. I can't do it, ya Rabb. No dua to Allah to say, Ya Allah, help me. He just does it. Put your hand in your pocket, in your sleeve, you take it out, it's going to be white. Another miracle I'm giving to you. Now so far Allah has asked him for a few things, some pretty shocking things. He's asked him to grab a snake. His hand has changed in color entirely. But Musa alayhi salam has no reaction. He's fine to all of this. But when Allah tells him, اذهب إلى فرعون إنه طغى. Go to Fir'aun. Go to Fir'aun. He's the one in fact that has rebelled. At this point, Musa alayhi salam makes dua. So I would expect that he would turn to Allah and say, Ya Rab, you want me to go talk to Fir'aun? Can you deal with his army? Can you put them all to sleep so I can go talk to him? Or can you pull him out of Egypt so I can talk with him over here? It might be safer for me. But he asks for none of this. He asked for none of this. This is the first command Allah gave Musa alayhi salam, that he didn't just do it. He said, Ya Allah, before I do it, I need some help. And so now we're learning that when Allah tells us to do something, you don't say, Ya Allah, I can't do it. You ask Allah for what you need so you can do it. He says, أولاً ربي اشرح لي صدري. Ya Allah, my master, expand my chest. كي نسبحك كثيرا ونذكرك كثيرا إنك كنت بنا بصيرا. It's coming later in the same surah. So we can do a lot of dhikr of you, tasbih of you, and mention you a lot because you've been keeping an eye on us all along. In other words, you've been keeping an eye on me since my birth. I should have died the day I was born because the soldiers were looking to kill him. And he could have died when his mother threw him in the basket. Then to throw the baby into the river, the basket could flip over. He could have died there too. Then he goes inside and when the soldiers see him, they could kill him right on sight. Then he's almost dehydrating. The baby's not drinking any milk. He could have died then too. There are like 10 times he could have died. So he says, Ya Rab, you've been keeping me alive all this time. I know you'll keep me alive, but I need to remember that. Sometimes it's easy to say it, it's hard to remember it. So he says along with his brother, كَيْ نُسَبِّحَكَ كَثِيرًا وَنَذْكُرَكَ كَثِيرًا إِنَّكَ كُنْتَ بِنَا بَصِيرًا. You've been keeping an eye on me all along. Ya Allah, how will you let me go now? So now what gives us calmness of the heart? What gives us calmness of the heart when we have a difficult task in front of us is a lot of dhikr of Allah, that Allah is watching. إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَنَا إِنَّ اللَّهَ بَصِيرٌ. Ya Allah, I know I can't do it, but Ya Allah, give me what I need so I can do it. But if you can help me, by your help I will succeed. So we don't start with I can't do it. Every time you get to a point where you say and I say I can't do it, we turn to Allah in dua. That's our iman.